Hello from Chem Help ASAP. We're going to continue talking about the idea of hybridization. And to try to make this more concrete, we're going to try to discuss hybridization in the context of how it might affect paint. So on the top half of the screen, we have four cans of paint. One is white and three are black. And our job is to make different shades of gray paint. So what are our options? Well, we could take our white paint, mix it with one can of black paint, and that would give us two cans of some new color, some dark gray color or light gray color. And so we would get two mixtures of white and black. And we'd have left over our two cans of black paint. Now, if we instead mix this, what if we mixed our white can with two cans of black paint? Well, we would get three volumes of some white, black, and I'm going to put a 2 next to the B because we have twice as much black. So we get this three cans of this white-black mixture plus some leftover black paint. And then finally, if we took our white and mixed it with all three black paints, black cans, we would get a total of four can volumes of black, a white and black, three times as much black as white. And that's what we get. No matter how we mix this, we always get four volumes back out. We put four volumes in, we get four out. The same exact idea comes with hybrids. So when we do hybridization, just as we always involve the white to get our gray colors, we will always use the S to get our new hybrids. So we could mix our S orbital with one P orbital, and that would give us two new orbitals, and we call them SP hybrids. And we'd have two leftover P orbitals. We can take our S orbital and mix it with two P orbitals, and that would give us instead three new hybrid orbitals, and we call them SP2s because we use two P's, not just one. We would have one leftover P orbital. We could also take our S and mix it with all three P orbitals. We would then get a total of four hybrid orbitals. They would be called SP3 hybrids, and we'd have zero leftover P orbitals. So this is the idea of what happens in hybridization. We're actually taking orbitals, and we can think of them, if we want, as physical objects, and we are mixing them together to get new objects. And those new objects are not S and P orbitals, but they are SP hybrid orbitals. Sometimes we do have leftover P orbitals, but we get new orbitals. The old orbitals are consumed to make the new orbitals.